Who doesn't indulge in some junk food once in a while? I know it tastes so good. But do you know how processed sugar can manipulate your thinking capacity and fluctuate your mood? Processed sugar is the cocaine of the food industry. As long as you keep feeding sugar to your body, it will continue to crave sugar endlessly. But if you choose to eat a fruit every time you crave sugar, you not only consume nutrients, but eventually train your taste buds and mind to replace its love for processed sugar with natural sugar and eventually put an end to sugar craving. In time, you end up appreciating how tasty and satisfying natural sugars are. So let us understand how we can make healthier choices and learn what happens beyond the tongue.
Hi there. Today I have with me Mrs. Dhanya, who is a certified nutritionist. And I'm here to ask her five important questions that you would be interested in. Welcome, Dhanya. Thank you for your time. Please tell us, what is your background?
Hi, this is Dhanya Lakshmi, and I've done my master's in food and nutrition. I pursued the fellowship in holistic nutrition and in diabetic education. So this is about me.
You know, the first topic that I want to discuss is about sugar.
Right.
You know, I have a sweet tooth, and most Indians and most people in the world also have a sweet tooth. But I want to understand how it manipulates our mental health, emotions, and psychology in the long run.
Right. Okay. So sugar plays a major role in with our emotions. When we really feel sad or depressed, we tend to eat chocolates or sweets, something we search around the house to eat something sweet. So it is not about the sweet tooth that we have, it is about the thoughts that we have in our mind. When we are overthinking, we tend to eat more sweets because our mind, the brain is like, you know, craving for glucose. Mm. So this is a cycle actually when we see. The more sugar you eat, the more your body starts craving, your mind starts craving, and you end up in obesity. And that in turn leads you to depression or to sadness or something like that. Again, you tend to eat sweet, and it is a cycle. Yeah. When you have more calories in your body and you don't tend to burn it, what happens is that carbs is being converted into sugars in the body. So that in turn is also affecting your body weight and your emotions. So this is a cycle.
But in the long run, does it make one lose self-confidence also?
Definitely, because than overweight, when your mind is wandering, you're not stable enough to think for yourself, the anxiety arises, the confidence goes down, and you will not be able to even face your own family members to put up your thoughts. Have a balanced food. Instead of craving for a lot of sugars and carbs.
Yeah. I've heard a lot about mixing raw food and cooked food leading to acidity issues and digestive issues. And there's a lot of research, you know. Some people say never to mix sprouts with cooked food. So I want to find out today from you, is it really true and what happens if we mix them?
Right. So eat the raw food first, then continue with the cooked food. So why is that? Because when you start eating, your digestive enzymes are more in the beginning. Mm. Because of the cooked food, it has already been processed. Mm. The cooking processes the digestibility there, and it is easy to digest. Okay. So it is fine, you eat it later. And regarding to the sprouts, when you say, see the sprouts, why do you sprout it? Mm. Because the quality of the protein increases, and the vitamins and the minerals in that increases, especially the B complex and vitamin C and all those things. So when you start cooking it, put it on a heat, it all deteriorates, it destroys. So that process can be minimized, at least if you cannot eat it raw, put it on a steam. Instead of cooking it, you know, pressure cooking it or something like that, put it on a steam for a couple of minutes, then add it to your salad and have. But instead, if you eat it raw, it's better.
Okay, so instead of boiling it, have raw sprouts if possible.
Yes. I do it in the same way. When we go for a wedding, it's a complete meal that it's going to be served. After everything is served, only we tend to eat. Yes. So eat the salad, then go for the cooked vegetable, then go for your rice and curry.
I hope you remember that. Make sure not to eat your sprouts and salad at the end of the meal or in between. Try and eat that first so that it gets digested easily before you move on to the cooked food. coming to something that you've commonly heard, but what is more common is that most of us don't follow it. That is having your breakfast and never skipping it. A lot of people in their college days or even in the work life skip their breakfast because they don't have time to get ready in the morning. And even if they tend to eat breakfast, it's like very light, you know. They don't understand that you have to make it the biggest meal of the day. Please tell us why it is so important and what will happen if they keep skipping their breakfast over years.
Right. So when you break the fast, what happens is like your body is already in a fasting stage where all the enzymes are ready to take the food and digest it. So at that point of time, when you give the body the required nutritious food, the healthy food, the first meal, it's going to absorb all the nutrients which is going to be required. There's a proverb like, eat an apple a day to keep the doctor away. Why they say an apple? Because apple has got the minimum amount of nutrition than compared to the other fruits. Minimum, very least, it is trace amount. When you eat that apple also, the trace amount of nutrients is going to be absorbed to your body completely. Okay, so do not miss that trace amount also. That is what they mean actually. So the basic five foods that I call it is the carbs, protein, your vegetables, fruits and your fats, everything can be added to the first breakfast. If it's going to be a simple upma, it's fine. Add a teaspoon of ghee to it, put all the vegetables possible, add some green peas, anyways rava is there for the carbs. So almost everything is being covered now. So the basic five food groups is being covered and you get all the nutritious food. So people do not really focus on upma. Upma is like just an emergency food or something, but you can still make it healthy by adding all the the required nutrition for the day. Even the herbs can be added, the coriander, the mint, everything can be added to it. So the first meal can be really fantastic along with a small cup of fruit.
Okay.
So you start with the fruit and have a good amount of balanced breakfast. So that is one thing. And secondly, now you would have heard about the upcoming trend of fasting is like intermittent fasting.
Yeah.
Diet. Right. So this is an extended fasting.
Okay.
So our usual fasting from the dinner to the breakfast, it is like 8 to 12 hours sometimes. So this is an extended fasting till 16 hours. Mm-hmm. So 16 hours of fasting and 8 hours of feeding window. So this is also fine, but when you break the fasting, it is really important how you eat it and what you eat.
I know a lot of my friends who start their day with chai sutta. You know, a lot of people I've seen in my workplaces as well, you know, they start their day with a cup of tea and a cigarette. If they continue to do this over months and years together, skipping breakfast, what happens? What happens to the body?
See, actually the enzymes secreted in the body is quite acidic, as we know, the hydrochloric acid which is in the stomach and everything. So you will not be able to concentrate, you will not be able to focus on things that you do. So the first meal is very important of the day to make your focus for the work, in a very precise way.
Yeah.
So that is really important.
So remember that if you are starting your day with chai and sutta or junk food, you can end up having stomach ulcers. And I know a friend who had to get operated because of stomach ulcers. So you don't want to go through that. It's very painful and it will keep you out of action for months together. Now, the common trend is that most people have their dinner after 8, you know. And there are studies which suggest that you should eat before sunset. That is at 5:30 or 6:30 even, you know, sometimes till 7. And I see a lot of people outside India following this routine, you know. They eat their dinner before 7:30 and then they have a light snack around 9:30, maybe a fruit or carrots. I know a lot of people who even eat at 10, 11, and this could be because of their work life or things that they can't control.
Right.
So why do they say that you should eat before sunset or at sunset? And why do they say not to eat after 8 p.m.?
Our activity comes down when we get into the evening mode. So the coffee also, you should push it to either 3 o'clock or 3:30. Before 4, you should wind up the coffee. 4 is also late. Because when you drink coffee after 4, what happens is like your sleep is disturbed.
Okay.
So the coffee, the caffeine in the coffee is being processed and it is being carried almost like 6 to 8 hours.
Mm.
So your sleep is almost disturbed in that cycle. That is one. And secondly, coming to the dinner, yeah, it is better to have an early dinner at least 2 hours before you go to bed, because 9 o'clock you have your dinner and till 11 o'clock you lie on the bed and fiddle with the phone and then go to sleep. That doesn't come into the account.
Okay.
Before 8 o'clock, finish your dinner. Let it not be too heavy. A very minimal amount of carbohydrate, a little bit of protein, which is easily digestible, and some vegetables to it, because this carbs has to be there a little bit to make you sleep. Otherwise, you know, while going to bed, you'll feel hungry.
Okay.
So it's better to have a little carbs. Otherwise, you can go for a bowl full of soup, mixed vegetables with some green peas, some tofu in it, and some corn. So that it gives a good combination of everything.
Is there something connected to sunset? Why they say that?
It's actually the cycle.
Okay.
The sunrise and sunset is a cycle where your body's hormones also start secreting accordingly. There are hormones which secrete in the night. There are hormones which secrete in the morning. To keep you fresh, to keep you calm, to make you sleep and everything. So everything has to be in the cycle when you follow the timings properly.
So it's important that you channelize your energy and your activities so that you are in sync with nature. For a lot of us who are into fitness or who want to just get healthier, protein is an important factor. And there are a lot of us who are vegetarians or even vegans. So this is something that people would have researched about, but I want to know from you personally, how can vegetarians gain the required amount of protein intake per day as suggested by their BMI? How can they acquire that amount of protein on a vegetarian or a vegan diet?
Right. As I gave an example of upma in the beginning, see, when you add green peas to the upma, you're adding some amount of protein there.
Mm-hmm.
And if you're going to make the upma not with white rava, you're going to put millets to it, again the millets have protein in that. Right? And coming to the vegetables, like, you know, the broccoli, avocados, all these have got good amount of protein. And even lentils, sprouts, tofu, and the tempeh. So that is also rich in protein. And the paneer.
Paneer
is also rich in protein, I guess.
If you're not a vegan.
Right. So there are umpteen number of protein foods which is available, but we do not tend to plan our meal prior. So instead of thinking about the colors alone, think about the variety of foods, the basic five food groups which is going to be there in the food. That's really important. So the mix can be like almonds, walnuts, cashews, pistachios, the sunflower seeds, pumpkin seeds, chia seeds or flax seeds. All these things you can mix it and keep take a handful. You get proteins, you get a lot of vitamins and minerals through it. You're done. You're done for the day.
So with that, thank you so much for sharing this information. I hope it helps our viewers.
Thank you so much for the opportunity.
Hope you gained knowledge from this video and made some notes. Keep in mind that if you plan your meal and follow simple rules or simple tips that we share in this video, your life, your body, your energy levels can really transform. So make sure that you like this video and do subscribe to the channel. If you think this could help someone that you know, please share the video with them. Thanks again. See you in the next video.